You can find it on any bag.
What's the name of it?
Folks are black, you've been from all over.
What's the name of it?
Beaumont.
Beaumont? Where the heck is Beaumont?
Thank you. boy. Let the Lord hear your voice.
Ren. Ren McCormick.
Ren.
Ren, is that perhaps short for something?
No.
This room is going round about the new kid. And everybody's talking to the blue. Cause you know how a stranger is. And he's not dumb, he's dangerous. But either way, at least it's something new.
Now, I invite you to join my wife, Vi, and our daughter, Harry, in this morning's convocation. Been excited about your coming to live with them.
Lou and Wes have been my rock.
It's been no trouble at all. I thought this would be right into the guest room.
So, Ren, where did your uncle put you?
Oh, you remember that old tool shed over the garage?
Wes, that place is a greasy dump.
Well, no more.
Picture this. Powder blue wallpaper and chocolate brown carpet.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
So, when will Mr. McCormick be joining us?
Mr. McCormick won't be joining us.
My husband and I are separate.
Yes, he ran out to find himself.
Ren, please.
Hi, hi. I made some of my whole house cookies. Tastes better than over every recipe in your kitchen.
Well, come and join us, Mr. McCormick. Eleanor wants to show us what heaven tastes like.
Please call me Ethel, only if you call me Vi.
Save me a cookie, Ethel.
So, Ren, are you all set for school tomorrow?
Oh, yes. What's your help getting registered?
Reverend. Did you hear that the new English teacher is planning to introduce some vulgar modern novel to our American Lit course?
Yes, Slaughterhouse-Five. I've received several calls.
Slaughterhouse-Five? Koopa cover to cover! That's one bitchin' story! Slaughterhouse-Five, right? Yeah, it's classic.
Do you read much?
Maybe in another comic, but...
In any time, of course.
Tom Sawyer is a classic.
Daddy? Rusty and the girls are doing all the murders. Can I?
Tonight is a school night.
Aw, Daddy.
Ask your mother.
We already did that. It was okay with her, but it was okay with you, so it's okay with you.
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock.
Great sermon, Reverend.
Thank you, Rusty.
What you said about Walt Whitman and rock and roll, listening to the music in your soul and all that, I mean, I was like, who knew?
High praise, indeed. Gentlemen?
I, on the other hand, thought my daddy was never going to shut up.
Well then, Ariel, why don't you just talk to him?
Why? He never listens to me. And anyway, I... Up in Beaumont.
Howdy!
Ooh, you are cute. I mean, Joe, isn't
Uh-huh.
And he knows he's cute. Don't you think when you do?
Uh-huh. Ouch. Ooh, baby, you got that sweet stuff.
Hey, put your tongue stuck in your mouth and let's get out of here.
See ya. Where are you going? Where do you think?
Ooh.
And if the question ever comes up, I was with you guys all evening, right?
Are you asking us to lie for you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
small world or what? I'm your new classmate.
Howdy!
Leave that poor boy alone.
Hey, mister, you bumped me.
Sorry.
Don't you ever look where you're going?
Hey, I said I was sorry.
Ain't you that new guy from Chicago?
Perhaps.
Smart out, huh? Listen here, fella. You push somebody, they push back. Next thing you know, you got... two people pushing, get it?
Got it. Let me ask you a question. They saw Matt's closure about that ad?
That's some kind of stupid joke.
No, it's a really good one.
That's it, man. I'm gonna kill you.
Oh, please kill me! Kill me, kill me! That's the most interesting thing I've heard since I've hit town!
Huh?
Wait, McCormick.
And you are?
Willard. Willard and Hewitt.
Willard, what do you guys do around here for a good time? Besides that, you got any clubs?
Nope.
What about movies?
Nope.
What about malls?
Nope.
Nope,
and nope. We do a bull from and find out the leaders, lady.
Man, I can never do what you guys do.
Yeah, what do we do?
Nothing! I never walk when I can run. I don't believe I ever could. People try to smoke me down. Say before you really should. Kick back, get you, but I can't stand still.
I can say that.
Doctor, he said, son, I cannot offer you a pill. So I never found relief, and now I've got to move until I pay my bill. I can't stand still.
I'm here to walk.
Back where I come from, life's never humdrum. I wish I could take step. Oh, beat up the world that I beat. Life is sweet, ain't no doubt, grab a seat. Check it out.
Such a turn.
watching a guy fly in the face of authority, isn't it, Lemmy Joe?
Well, was she serious?
Serious as a heart attack.
Dancing is against the law?
Has been for 5.5 years, ever since the accident.
What accident?
The Batani Bridge accident! You've never heard of the Batani Bridge accident?
If I did, would I be going like this?
Lindsay, should I take this one?
Please.
Be my guest. There were these 4 kids we all grew up with. And one night they were driving back from a big dance over in Baylor County. And maybe it was the rain that night and maybe they were being a little bit wild, but somehow they lost control of the car. It skidded across the bridge, crashed to the railing, and fell 35 feet into the Batani River.
Are there any survivors? Oh, God.
Yeah. And when the sheriff's office released the autopsy report, they claimed there were traces of alcohol and marijuana in the blood. Everybody in town went nuts.
And that's when Reverend Warren got so righteous. He started blaming anything and everything. Liquor, drugs, rock and roll.
And dancing?
You got it.
He convinced the town council was a sin. Just like that. They passed a law.
Wait. Reverend Warren has that kind of power?
Reverend Warren? He is the power. He is the law.
Man, how can you guys stand a lid on that?
Practice. Years of practice.
It's not like Chicago. It must be so cool to live in a city where you can walk down the street and get mugged by people you don't even know.
Yeah, I miss that. I thought living in a small town would be like one big happy family.
Let me tell you about that family. There's some way every time you live in a
every time you turn around. His head shaking the minute he crossed the line.
And his eyes are
for me to be good.
that you've been fired.
Every day, Corbin. Every day.
Don't exaggerate.
I feel hush. You're not helping anything.
Brad, what happened?
Nothing I should be fired for. Willard came by the store and he wanted change for a dollar. And when Mr. Dillingham came in and saw my hand on the door, he went crazy. He accused me of stealing.
That's because everything you do makes people suspicious.
Are you on drugs?
No! But why didn't you frisk me? I'm sure you've already searched through everything in my room.
Your man apologized to your uncle.
Look, young man, I know I'm not your father.
You can say that again!
What?!
Don't say anything, Ethel.
I can't not say anything! I don't know how to do that, Wes!
Ethel, hush, please.
Look, I realize that we are...
Ethel! Right now, just don't say anything.
Thank you. Do not is it there, oh my God, I'm on the fire, you see.
running late. Chuck's gonna lose it.
Ariel, what's going on? We had a day and a half hour ago.
Chuck, I'm sorry.
I don't like you making a fool out of me.
Why would you if you do such a good job of it yourself?
Shut up, Rusty!
Will you be joining these ladies for dinner?
When I say meet me at 8, what am I, talking to myself?
No, you're right. Calm down.
Don't tell me to calm down. Don't ever tell me what to do. Look, I know what your friends think of me, and that's bull. I am the best party in this town, baby. And those three dogs ought to be tied up under the porch. Let's go.
No.
Get in the truck.
No!
Excuse me?
I said no, Chuck. What part of that don't you understand?
You said no 1,000 times before. Is it the one time you mean it?
Leave me alone, Chuck. Don't.
Hey, I believe the lady said no.
And I believe this is none of your business.
Brad, don't.
Ariel, who invited this clown?
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't believe we've been formally introduced. Run for it.
Get your hand out of my face! And get your face out of my sight!
Hey, Chuck, you're looking for a friend at this party!
Hey, let's go!
Willard, don't lose me this job!
Aw, oh, man, let me nail him!
Hey, is that Bob over here?
No, of course not. We were just discussing the safety and comfort of one of our valued customers.
What? You think that's fun?
Francis, your paper truck is in a handicapped parking space. That's a place to reserve for people with physical, not emotional disabilities.
You haven't seen the last of me, Cranston.
Can I please kick this face in?
Willard, what is it that your mom says? Before you make a fist, make sure it's your fight.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, this is not your fight. And won't dress you guys have curfews? And forming.
I know. I'll turn in my skates.
Listen, I'll see you here tomorrow after school.
Really? So I'm not fired?
Nope. Not yet. Well, give me a push, honey.
You are either very brave or very stupid.
Which do you think?
I have a bit of my mind. Want to see something?
Don't you have a curfew?
Oh, you're right! Please, my daddy invented it. But don't you think rules are made to be broken? Come on.
No, thanks. I just say, you really are something, aren't you?
What do you mean?
I mean, the whole package. Reverend's daughter, Chuck Cranston's girlfriend.
Guilty.
Just a church going gal with some sexy red cowboy boots.
My daddy hates me wearing these boots.
And you love that, don't you? Getting up all in his face.
That way he'll notice when I'm gone.
Well, where are you gonna go?
College, for starters. I've applied to some places my dad doesn't even know about. I want to speak 5 languages and see the world. He wants me to teach English Lit in Baylor County. They don't even speak English in Baylor County.
I can't really see you as a teacher.
Thank you. Neither can I. I'll leave that to my daddy.
Well, he's a preacher, not a teacher.
When you're good at it, it's the same thing. And he used to be really good.
What changed?
Mine. Closed it.
I noticed.
He used to be so open, so inspiring. You've seen him give people hope when hope was gone. I've watched him change lives.
Well, if you love him so much, why do you want to take him off?
Didn't say I love him.
Boy, do I know what you mean. My dad.
Yeah, what happened there?
He just left. Walked out. No goodbye. Nothing.
You got lots to say to him.
Lots.
Like what?
No, I don't.
Tell it to the train, I do.
How could you be so stupidly mobbing me? I hate you! I have a feeling you've been kissed a lot, and I think I'd suffer by comparison.
You don't think much of me, do you?
I think of you more than I expected. Come on, I'll walk you home.
Somebody's eyes are watching.
That my prayers seem to fail me is at the bridge table.
No, come on, say hello to everyone. Hi, I'm Eleanor McCormick. Daddy, friends.
What's up, Reverend? Principal Carter! Coach Dunbar.
Hi, Mrs. Dunbar.
Hi, Mrs. Moore.
Welcome, Red.
Whoa, poker night.
Ooh. Ariel, all this time you thought you were upstairs in your room.
It's quite hard to impose a curfew on the people of my congregation when I can't seem to enforce one in my own home. Well, what's that old saying? It's the shoemaker's children who always go barefoot?
Well, we couldn't go at the time. I'll walk you guys out.
Boy, I can sure clear a room. It's a rare talent. You know what? I'm gonna take that as a compliment. Oh, I can assure you it was not meant as one. I believe this is yours.
Thanks for, you know,
walking you home.
That too.
Well, Reverend, this was fun, don't you think?
Someone's gotta put a foot down. I didn't say anything.
I don't enjoy being her jailer. I don't relish telling her no. But then I think, what if I fail her? How can I just let her go? I strive to be a good creature. I try not to go overboard. But then I think, if I can't reach her, how can I face my Lord? Heaven help me shoulder my load. Every day's a struggle still. Someone's got to take the high road. If I don't, will I became a man of God to do his word, to spread his word, to ease some pain and dry some tears. That was the plan. But I've heard that thought twice. If only I knew that I'd spent all of my time saying, no, no, don't do that. Everyone prays for salvation. I'm happy to give them the tools. The problem is my frustration. Nobody wants to have rules. So heaven help me shoulder my load. Every day's a struggle still. Someone's got to take the high road.
Anybody you know?
Well, I didn't take names, if that's what you mean.
McCormick, since you're not making trouble, if I'm getting away. And Ariel, I would advise you to stay away from this guy. I've been asking, and I am.
Oh, my father calls. Surprise, surprise.
And to cooperate will make all of our lives much easier.
Gee, if my daddy gives you a call, will you get off of my back?
That mouth grows across the reason your daddy walked down in the first place.
Count to 10, man. Mama says count to 10.
You'd be wise to take your friend's advice. Ariel, get back to practice. McCormick, get down and give me 20.
You're joking.
You're right. Make it 50.
He's not faking, Coach. He's really hurting.
Thanks for the diagnosis. Dr. Willard, you can give me 50 as well. As a matter of fact, you all can give me 50, courtesy of Mr. McCormick. Just do it. One, two, I can't hear you.
Three, four.
Only 46 more.
Five, six.
Is he gone yet?
Seven, eight.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Brent. Sorry, it's just, this whole dang town is so wound up.
Amen.
You guys have no place to blow off steam.
You said it.
At least in Chicago, we can go to the clubs and go dancing.
Hey. Maybe you are at the Coach dancing.
Willard, you are so...
What? What are you thinking?
That's it?
What?
We're gonna throw a dance! We are gonna throw a party! Then that's going right off its track!
You're just asking for a fight.
Hey, bring it on!
Are you ready to take on Reverend Moore?
I'll take on anybody.
You up town round?
I'll fight to you all! If there's one thing we're fighting for, it's freedom!
If there's anything worth the fight, it's worth the fight. Oh, every time I hit, oh, maybe change my plan. I'm crossing the line, jumping the track. what it takes to carry out the man who fights his dreams. We can face it down right now, buddy. Once you're standing on your own, you will not retreat if you
to the four young people who held Beaumont's brightest future.